Hi. Quails? Hi, John. Hi, Tracy. Thanks. Anyone can hear me? Good connection. Connection all right? Hi, Patricia. Yeah. I just want briefly remind my friends, maybe not all know all details, that on last hearing of my committals to prison for this heinous crime of exposing, criticizing social workers, I offered a compromise to Medvay. I offered to take all from Facebook, Twitter, stop all campaign if my son come back home. I would allow them some formalities. What I needed is right direction. And on a certain moment, they were ready to negotiate. And then, when I was talking to their barrister and to legal, and to solicitor, I produced a letter from my son, which he signed, that he wants to come back home. He wants to see me more. And legal solicitor of Medvay said, well, it's important letter because wishes and feelings of a child very important. So clearly, her and barrister, they wanted to broker some agreement. And guess who blocked it all? Of course, and Domini. They showed letter to the judge, and he was horrified. My friends, can you imagine that child signed a letter that he wants to come back home, he wants to see father and to instruct his own solicitor? And they were horrified. How could it happen? Sorry if I'm repeating myself. I just want to be clear because tomorrow I will start something. How could it happen? Where was supervisor? So my son is not supposed to have his own will, not supposed to sign letters. He's supposed just a just some puppet. It's incredible. So and compromise didn't work. They didn't want to make any compromise. Furthermore, after this hearing, I was asked not to protest because my legal advisors, they were trying to negotiate with Medvay. It didn't work either. And I went for judicial review, but it's not sort of about all case. It's one of attempt to make something positive. Anyway, I get fed up. Just I brief you, explain you that they took my life from me, you know. They took my life. So what they expect? That I will live with it? I'm not going to live with it. They have to accept that unless they will return my child, it will be difficult for them to operate. Prison, not prison, I really, I don't care too much anymore.
reason of, I'm not going to run around them, you see, go in circles. Anyway, thank you, Vic. Anyone from London, France, wants to support me tomorrow, just give me a shout. I'm planning to be in London tomorrow. Will be helpful. I can't sit and wait destruction of all my life. I can't do that. Yeah, John, I understand. It's a bit of, I try to separate this question. You see, if parents who fight for their children, they will wait till all corruption will disappear. I'm afraid they'll have to wait till the rest of their lives. Can't take it like an excuse either. I don't know what exactly you mean by that, John, but corruption is everywhere. You won't find any country where corruption wouldn't exist. By some reason, in this country, children became subject of it. But I'm not here to solve political questions. Go Blackburn on August 22. Well, first of all, I have to know what will happen with me till 22, you see. Whether... I will be in prison or not in prison. You know that warrant from my arrest already in the court. And I don't know what Medvedev will do. I want my son back. Nothing new. All parents want their children back. It's quite silly, I would say, from them. They have to understand that. I will find ways that their ego won't suffer. But if they're stubbornly do not want to return a child who has no reason to be in care, because all cases farce. All cases farce and they know it. Nothing will stop me. Tracy, very much grateful for your invitation. You do great things in Northern Ireland, but unfortunately... It's not in England, you see. I don't know what to say, really. I just wanted to mention that I tried the can egg. And I just get on end of my... That's it. End of road. What evil tricks from their side could be, I don't know. Can only tell me that it's quite regretful. They have nothing to do than to fight with desperate father. U.S. government help. Brenda, are you from U.S.? Well, U.S. government can do a lot, of course, you see. Can do a lot. Hi, Katrina. Everybody, hello. Thank you for watching. U.S. government. If I got friends in the U.S. government, probably never give up, yeah. Well, never give up till he's 21 or 18, yeah? Stolen 2 years and a half his. I would change the slogan. What can we do? Brenda, I mean, you primarily, do you work, you mean to say you work for the US government? It's a bit of a, just primarily, I don't know if you are friends or send me friend request. US government can do lots of things. course. You know my case, Brenda. So in the UK, people could be go to jail because they want their child back. And it get covered by their own judges. No, I'm a citizen. Tell people about, yeah, well, see, they are leaving Facebook, and Dominion, I couldn't find her on the Facebook. Member of the parliament, Raymond Chisti, he's also left Facebook. It's his empty profile is there. Child portfolio holder, Andrew McNess, he barred me, banned me from Facebook, banned me from Twitter. They try to avoid me, but I will find way. I will find ways to get them. I will try to do that. They will not ignore me. But you can't think straight. Well, John, don't talk about myself. Who told you that I feel low? I feel tired. I don't feel low. For what? They should feel low, bastards, because I will expose them big time. They'll be shamed everywhere. Now, why I should feel low? I'm tired, which is quite natural. Not a teenager anymore, so there is no way they break me. Guys, my friends, I'll go to bed soon. That's why I just a bit of... I don't think that from my last videos, Maidstone, you could see that I'm broken. Well, now I'm tired. It's quite natural. Michelle, my local MP will not help me, unfortunately. His name is Raymond Chisti. He denied me help. So I can't do it. I don't know. All legal things are, they do not exist for me. It's one gang who do all that. I tried my best. I tried. He didn't want even to see me. Keep sending my letters to counsel and counsel answering me back is useless, meaningless. I can think straight. What do you mean, John, I can't? Well, I think I can think straight. Tomorrow I will make protest action, hopefully. If anyone of you in London, people from London, you can help me tomorrow. Give me a call. It will be somewhere on the Victoria Line. Hopefully you will hear from me tomorrow. So you will see that I'm not, I don't need to prove anyone. I'm just tired. It's quite normal. Evening, you know, time to go to bed. Right. Thank you for your attention. If Medway, I don't understand why US media has not picked up on this situation. Well, I gave interview actually to US, to Radio Freedom. I gave interview. I got articles written about me by Christian Voice. But there is a total ban here. You see, in the UK, you can't write about children services. So 90,000 children there stay in care virtually without any voice. Brenda, those articles, it was just, it's basically, thank you for interest, is it just appeared, you see? If you will look on my wall, there are those articles. About fivefold altogether. He's the really one in the UK who is so, you know, courageous. People would like to write, but there are injunctions, which I think not workable. But media won't take it on because the government. Well, John, I would not really get such a negative mood, you know. I appreciate your advice, but first you said that I'm they make me feel low, narcissist government own media. I mean, I don't intend to fight with the British government, and I want to say it clearly and loudly. Also, I'm not going to fight with all corruption, and I also don't. I'm not going to find existence of corruption as an excuse to do what I want to do. You see. Government owns media. I have no clue who owns what. What I do know is that they would write if they could. There are some journalists who would like to write, they need sort of correct angle. But all fate of my son depends upon two people, by name of Anne Domini and Ian Sutherland. Ian Sutherland on Facebook. He is the director of Adult and Children's Services. That's all. They should make this decision. Bring my son home. My friends, it's a struggle. You see, there is no guarantees. You can approach those people if you feel like that. If maybe wants put me to prison, they will put me to prison. I can't help it, so I already accepted this reality. If they want to scare me off, they did not succeed. Thank you, Cecile, for your sharing. I try just to understand some Norwegian, but I just can't. Two years, 4 months. They already ruined him. The worst what they do, they ruin this link between father and the son. They're just waiting till he will disown me. Or will get used to his new place. Quite disgusting. And very hurtful, really. Don't want to cry on a Facebook, virtually, and complain. I don't make any threats toward them. I find it quite regretful and unfortunate. It's not that he won't forget you. It's not that. I'm not worrying about... It's Cecil, you see, I brought him up with a certain... Well, you know, like a father and a son, you see. Now he sees that some people have authority on him. Children get alienated, you see. Children get alienated, and almost every parent who is here will confirm that. So I'm not, that's how this evil works. I have to reestablish my authority by some ways. What he should do. Father trying 2.5 years, nothing happens, of course. He might think that father is a good man, but he cannot do anything. So, I find it very unfortunate that those two people, and Dominion in Sutherland, or one of them, I don't know, nothing better to do than to fight with a single desperate father. How can prevent alienation? Cecil, they do it very simple. I see him 4 times a year, you see. They don't allow him to see me. You know, so they want to break this link deliberately. And they think they will get away with it. They took all my life from me. All my life. All what I have, they took away from me. And they think they will get away and they will just carry on business as usual. No. They will not. I'm not going to run around them. I'm not going around them. Anyway, I just wanted to... Hi, Chris. Yes, I'm tired. Now I will go to bed. I'll be full of energy tomorrow, I hope. Anyone from London, give a shout tomorrow. I'm going to be somewhere far from Victoria Line. Only a satellite ring, but we'll wait till she is 18. Yes, Cecilia, we all are waiting, waiting. I mean, as I said, I'm not saying to anyone. I'm not going to allow them to behave as if I'm a slave or my son is a slave. And that's about it. Good luck. Thank you, John. You know, my friends, I tell you what. I can't imagine in any other country people will tolerate all that. That's one of wonders of the world, I would say. Tens of thousands of kids being taken like rabbits, like kittens, and people just accept it all. I don't know. Just try to get it. Try to get to make this in any other country. Break bloody heads, you see. They will not really survive for long, the social workers. And here it's everything as usual, everything normal. Yeah, adopt, come to hospital, take a child, keep him, blackmail him, not allowed to see his father. It's all normal, part of life. That's what pissed me off, really. Because looks like me and a few others can't accept it, and the rest accepting that. Well, Cecile, if you can do something not to wait till she's 18 or do something else, you know, anyway. Well, I'm not accepting that. You see what happened with Sarah Root. And the Clacton, wish I wasn't like, yeah, I know. You can't prevent alienation. Scoundrels. My friends, I hope tomorrow you'll hear from me. More active mood, I would say. Don't guess that you are in a city? Yeah, but I was thinking about parents who are also the same situation you see in London. There should be loads. That's what I meant. I don't expect help from anyone who is not the same situation. You're absolutely right. But not to help at least to stay near me, you see. They can promote their own case. But never mind. Okay. Good luck, everybody. God bless and good night.